Yeah.
We here.
Super Duty Tough Work, the most infamous podcast this side of Alum Creek.
This side of Alum Creek, word.
You know what I'm saying? We on the west side of Alum Creek. We want to let y'all know, you know what I mean? All you podcasters on this side of the creek, watch your back.
Watch out, we here.
Coming for y'all.
We
man.
Here, y'all.
Yeah, we set tripping. Alum Creek. That's the barrier. Stay on your side.
Word.
Album reviews. You know, we just broke down motherfucking Royce da 5'9". And now we're going to give our 2 cents on friend of the show, who actually was on the show a couple episodes back.
Facts.
You know, Count Bass D, CBD album.
Yeah.
I'm biased.
You are.
Because Count's my man.
Uh-huh.
Man, this record's entertaining.
Yo, I have to say.
Yeah.
I've never really listened to Count.
Yeah.
This is really my first time listening to a full Count Bass D album.
That's dope.
And I'm going to be honest. At first, I didn't know what to think about. like, first listen,
yeah.
I was like, okay. Yeah. Let me go back. Because it was very entertaining. Like, there's some really dope lines. Yeah. There's a lot of really dope things going on the record.
Yes.
But it's so unorthodox.
Yes.
It's so like.
It's bugged out.
It's bugged out, but it's not.
Right.
Like, it's in the pocket still.
Yeah.
But it's out there, but it's not. It's like weird. It's a weird thing. But after listening to this record, because like since you sent me the list of the albums and stuff, since we figured that out, these are like really the only records I've been listening to is the records that were on the list for us to review.
Yeah.
Like I find myself going back to this album because it's so short.
Yes.
And it's perfectly short.
See?
Perfectly short. Like, what is it? Like 20 minutes?
21 minutes.
21 minutes long. Like, it's super like.
Yeah.
I'm a fan.
Yeah.
I'm a big fan now. Like, I've been going back in his catalog. Like, yeah, man. Like, this record is super, super fresh. And I love the unorthodoxy of it.
See?
Like, it adds so much character and so much flavor to it. And yeah, man, it's a freaking beautiful record.
Yeah, I agree. Like, the thing that you're talking about, like that bugged out element account, that's like my favorite thing about him, because he's kind of such a straightforward dude. Like, if you kick it with him, he's your unique dude. But then you listen to his records, it's always some weird, funny, bugged out shit going on. And you're like, this is fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
But it's like you're saying, it's straightforward, but then it's bugged at the same time.
It's not.
Like,
it's...
how are you doing both of these things well? Because some people, when you talk about people who are, I guess, making quote unquote the real shit, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, it's like, yeah, beats, samples, whatever. They don't have like that bugged out thing.
Nah.
Like, was DITC ever bugged out?
Nah.
Straightforward. Was showing AG.
Straightforward.
Yeah. Was Gangstar ever bugged out?
Loop drum break.
Yeah.
Like, baseline. That's it.
It was never
filtered sample.
That's it. Yeah.
That's as
filtered
far.
Loop.
Right. As baseline.
Then sample. Then straightforward rhyme by keeping it real.
Right.
You know what I mean?
That was it.
That was it. They never were bugged out. Like, I mean, even Nice and Smooth wasn't bugged out.
Nah.
They would say some funny lines, but they weren't bugged. Like, Count, to me, is bugged.
Yeah.
And I mean that in the most positive, complimentary way as possible.
Like, am I the only one?
Yeah.
No,
am I the only one?
He don't rhyme at all. But
exactly.
It's almost like a Seinfeld episode.
Yeah.
Like, because he just points out, like, just all this random shit where you listening to it and you like, hell yeah.
That happened to me, too.
Yeah, I feel you, Count. I feel you.
Yeah.
Yep, that's me too. Yeah, man, it's such an entertaining record.
Yeah, man, and I was gonna say the same things you were. Like, yo, one of the strengths of it is that it's 11 songs, 21 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
You can't get bored with this record.
No, because you gotta go back.
Yeah,
you gotta go back
twice.
Yeah,
on the first listen is really 2 listens.
Mm-hmm.
Because by the time he's at the end, you're like, oh shit, it's over.
right.
I gotta rewind this shit.
Yeah, because I did Spotify and I was like, this ain't the same record. Hold up, it already went to, you know, his radio. I'm like, hold up, let me go back. Yeah, man.
Yeah. For the highlights, I got and I'm gonna say, so these are some of my highlights with some of the lines that jump out to me. The Nobody joint.
Oh, Nobody.
Where he's talking about like the OGs, no matter how much you show or how you prove these OGs from the 90s will still try to play you.
Hell yeah. Ooh.
Yeah. Get money from the tours overseas, but ain't made a record when a studio is free.
Facts.
He was talking that shit.
Facts.
On the
facts. And yeah. Then the hook is so good.
Too. Yeah.
The hook is so good.
And then, you know, the, like you saying, I can't tell.
I can't tell.
Why is that just so funny? Every time that sample comes in, man, it's I can't tell. It's just so fucking funny, man.
Oh, goodness.
No, this dude said, unapologetically man spread and mansplain. Stand up when I piss with no guilt or shame. Yo, he was cooking, man. Cat was cooking on this record.
Oh.
And then am I the only one? He says, the woman's right to put a baby on the next nigga is ironclad and protected.
Yes. Yes.
Yo, he was talking his shit on this record, man. He was in his bag, man. Yeah, I don't care how much you bob your head, I know when I hear a fat beat.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. So many joints.
Yeah, the Show Love joint is dope.
Mm-hmm.
That's one that feels almost like it's like rhymes. Like Dimes, like mm-hmm. he's got that bugged out R&B sample.
Yeah, it's like real 80s kind of feel. Yeah.
This is super dope. Took the MPC and the Bible Moms gave me, talking about bad relationships and shit.
Mm-hmm.
The Break Bread song, that's the last song on the record.
Mm-hmm.
That's the realest shit on it, because he's talking about just like, okay, what happens after this shit is over?
Mm-hmm.
Were you a dude to try to survive off of props and respect?
Yeah.
Or are motherfuckers gonna pay you for what you do? And it's a conversation everybody gotta have. And, you know, he said they swear there ain't no budget wearing Kanye sneakers. He said, you ain't no better than Doom, and Doom paid me.
Don't count.
Cook it.
Oh, yo, man.
Yeah, man. Count is my man.
Yeah,
and,
man.
And this one is like, it's such a refreshing record.
Yeah.
Because like, oh, yeah, this is that shit.
It's really, it's like, it's not. For me, even like Nosebone.
Yeah.
It's just a little interlude.
Yeah, that's it.
That's it. But it's so good. it's so good.
Yeah. The one song, the Be Mine song, I feel like that's a parody.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He starts out like, I don't want no space. And I want you to basically saying all the shit that dudes shouldn't do. Mm-hmm. And then the second verse talk about how he's just some player shit and you can't get it anyway. But he's just like.
Forever be.
Right.
Yeah, that shit's dope.
So yeah, man, this count, I gotta give it at least 4 out of 5 dylons, man.
Man, I'm going what 5,
it
is, man.
Because it's like, I don't find any flaws in it.
I'm going 5 dylons on it, because every song.
Yeah.
I think every song, I'm going 5. I'm going 5. So we can split it at 4.5.
4.5 out of 5 dylons.
Yeah, please. Man. Record is really dope. If you haven't heard this record yet, it's on Spotify. It's on us on all the streaming platforms. Give it a chance. You'll probably be like me if you haven't listened to any count. Like, it'll probably throw you off first couple listens, but give it a chance and listen to his lyrics. Listen to what he's saying, and it'll definitely brighten your day.
Yeah. And the thing too, man, I want to add is like, you know, obviously we are doing these album reviews, but anybody we've actually interviewed on this show, we would like to invite our fans to visit their catalog.
Yes, please.
There's a reason that we bring them on here. You know, we obviously respect and admire them as people, but even bigger than that, it's like as artists, it's like, yo, we feel that if we put them on here, they're worthy of your support. So please, anybody that we're talking about on this podcast that we had on that as guests, go check out that music.
Please do.
That's the way this shit stays alive. It's not this, you're not going to see no ads on the radio about count. You're not going to see no billboards. You're not going to see none of that other shit, nothing on Facebook but what we do have is platforms like this that we control, that we can make sure, instead of talking shit about bad music,
right,
we're giving us a spotlight and a highlight to dope shit.
Right.
And we'd like y'all to go support them.
Facts.
Okay. So we'll take a break and we'll be right back.
Yeah.